Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name's Andrea and this is Beauty with Andy. So I just wanted to show you that I have switched everything around again. So all this in here is from my everyday makeup drawer, and in my everyday makeup drawer there's just like hair tools, straighteners, curlers, because they was like underneath my dresser and I didn't like that. It just didn't look right. So and also, I had loads of these drawers here. I gave two of them to my niece, so she's putting her makeup in them. But then all these were like free, and rather than throw them out, I just wanted to utilise them. I don't know if I'm going to keep this set up the way it is, but we've got my lipstick pencils there, my Too Faced Melted Matte lipsticks there. This won't go in any of the drawers, so I've had to leave it on top. I'm project panning that anyway, so hopefully that will be out soon. Then in the top drawer, I've done it in order of what I would do my makeup. So we've got the primer, the Technique Strobe FX Cream Concealer, e.l.f. Shade Adjusting Drops, and that like NYX pencil, and I've just kept that in there for safekeeping. Then we've got my three foundations that I'm going to be using this week, and hopefully making more progress on the L'Oreal Infallible Total Cover. So that's that. Then the second drawer down is just powders. So we've got the Essence Brighten Up, the MUA Skin Define, and the Collection Sheer Loose Powder. And then there's quite a bit of room here. The next drawer down is highlighters and blushes. So these were like my Shop My Stash. So if you've seen my Shop My Stash video, you will have seen these. So there's no reason to go through it. I just wanted to show you what it looks like in the drawers. Then in here we've got my eyeshadows, some project pan items. Like those are project pan line, and at the back it's project pan. And then these here are just things that I want to use. Here we've got like mascara and brow products. There's a project pan lipstick there. It's not the best setup, but it will do for now. And then here is just bits and pieces like hand sanitizer, brow products, gel again, and like lip balms. So yeah, that's what it looks like. Let me just step back, see if I can show you. So that's what it looks like, and obviously it's close to that, which is my everyday makeup drawer as well, for when I'm using like things that I've shot my stash for. I don't think it looks too bad. I don't know if I'm going to be keeping it like this, like I said. And then I'll just show you what else. So we've got the other drawers here, then we've got all my makeup brushes here, some there as well. It needs to be, the desk needs to be organised a little bit better. These brushes are what I'm going to be using today. And like we've got the eyeshadow palettes there, the perfumes there, and then some lipsticks there. But yeah, this is what it's looking like at the moment. I just thought I would come on camera and show you, because you'll probably think to yourself, when I do my Shop My Stash next week, it's changed again. So I wanted to show you that it had indeed changed. Today we're going to be doing a Try It Thursday, like first impressions on some products that I've got that are fairly new to the collection, like the highlighters, that peach palette, and things like that. So let's get into that. Let's not keep this video too long. And yeah, let's
right,
get into
so
that.
We're going to be doing three looks, one palette with this little beauty. It's the Just Peachy Eyeshadow Palette. And it's not a new palette by any stretch of the imagination, but it is new to me. I bought it off someone that was selling it on Depop, and it does look really, really beautiful. And I bought it because I'm really into that peach vibe at the minute. So I just wanted to see what it looks like. So yeah, let's just go ahead and do a few looks with it and see how it performs. I might not be keeping it. It is an older palette. I do want to get the Colourpop Just Peachy palette. That looks really, really nice. But I did want to try this one first just to see if I do still like peach. The only thing I've got on my face at the moment is the L'Oreal Infallible Oil, which is really, really nice. I'm going to turn my hair back. Might just tie it back half up, half down. Right, so that should do it. So now we need to get the brushes out. Let me just do that because they're all squished in
right,
here.
So I think I've got enough brushes.
The only thing is, because it's obviously a peach palette, it doesn't have that cream ivory shade. So I need to get that, and I also need to get my Revolution concealer, Conceal and Define. So we'll just go ahead and do that. My pointed foundation. Because it doesn't have like a cream ivory shade in that peachy palette from Primark, I'm going to be using this, and it's the white chocolate shade. Right, so they don't have names on, so I'll just have to point them out. So firstly, I'm going to go in with this one. It's like a light pink peach. And I don't know how these are going to perform on the eye, but I have done swatches. Ooh, that's quite pigmented. Oh, I'm getting a whiff of the smell of this palette. It's not nice. It's blending out quite nice. It's blending out really nice, in fact. I just don't like the smell of it, guys. I mean, everyone complains about the Too Faced peach products, how it's artificial, but this one really does smell artificial. I actually like the scent of the Too Faced peach products. Don't like the scent of this. Just gonna blend it out with this BH Cosmetics one, just to make it a little bit more seamless. This eye's looking better than this eye, which always happens with me on my left eye. That's better. Next. I don't know what to use next. That one's too light. We'll be using that in the next look, I think. Then we've got the browns. Actually, that's a little bit darker. Let's go in with that one. Just underneath to make it a little bit more darker. And then what I might do is put a bit of the brown in the outer corner. Time for a drink. Right, so that's look one done. I just want to show you this palette. I mean, that's the brown shade. Look at all that fallout. Can you see it? All that fallout there. So that's with the brown shade. That's something I don't like straight off the bat. But this is look number one. So let's go ahead and do look number two now. So far I've put the Revolution Conceal and Define on, and I've also put the white chocolate shade on, so we can just go back into this just peachy palette. So I think I'm going to use this middle peach shade here all over the crease. Let's just take the shades off this brush what I was using before. So yeah, let's go into that shade. Right, so from my experience with the mattes, they are really, really pigmented. Like a little bit goes a long way. Which is nice, because you don't need that much. But look at it. Just blend that. And I might try this like really light brown over the top of it. It might make it muddy, but let's try it. No, it doesn't seem to be making it muddy. Blend them in. Looking quite nice actually. I am dreading going out there this evening, guys. I've left my umbrella at my mum's yesterday because I was in a rush to go, so I don't have an umbrella. I'll just have to find a jacket with a hood on, but yeah, it's not looking too great out there. Right, now let's put some of the Too Faced Chocolate Bar White Gold shade on. Yeah, again, quite a lot of fallout in them too that I've just used. I'm just trying to figure out what I want to use now. And that's quite chunky. That one, I don't think I'll be using. It's just, look at it. On my finger, I don't like the look of that one. Right, I'll be using that at the end. So the only other shimmer that we haven't used is this one, so we'll have to go in and use it. It's like an antique gold shade, so let's see. Like that one, let's see how this one performs. Ooh, nice. I bet this would make a nice inner corner highlight as well. I like this look better than the first one. I just don't like the smell, guys, it's horrid. I did only pay a couple of pounds for this palette though, so it's not the be all and end all, is it? Just wanted to try it out. Right, so that's that. I don't really have anything that I could use for an inner corner, so maybe we could just use this Too Faced chocolate bar. I didn't do that last time. And there really is only the shade Champagne Truffle, which is quite pink toned, but we'll just use it anyway. It's very brightening. So is that, guy, look number two done. Sorry about that. So this is the finished look. Very, very peachy. With these palettes, they're like very monochromatic. You're not going to get much different looks unless you just went in like with the darker mattes and didn't use any of the peach shades. That would give you kind of a smoky, blown out look, I guess. But if you just use the peach shades, which is what I got the palette for, then all the eyeshadow, all the looks that you create are going to look the same. So we're going to do look
right,
three.
So I've just done the rest of my skincare.
So now we're going to be doing, like, putting all the rest of my face makeup on. So we're going to start with this. Right, so I don't know what's going on with this CoverGirl True Blend foundation. It's got quite a lot still left in. It could be the pump, so I'll wash the pump out later. But literally, nothing's coming out. So I think some product's stuck in the pump. So yeah, hopefully I'll be able to use this. Otherwise, I'm a little bit... Oh... I don't really have a lighter foundation, so I'm in a bit of trouble if I can't sort this one out, because this one is a favourite and I can't get hold of it. I've been into TJ Hughes so many times for this and they just don't do it anymore. So yeah, I definitely need to be on the hunt for a good dewy foundation. Maybelline, I'm thinking about getting that new one that Maybelline have just brought out. But that'll be in a few weeks' time, so I don't know what I'll do without it. If basically I can't get this one to get any product out, then I'm not going to be able to use this, and I'll just have to make do with kind of what's the right shade in my foundation drawer. But I'll keep you posted on that. And I think I'm going to store that like that. Sorry, you can't see it. Like that, and so all the product is going to come to the front. So let's just do that. Yeah, like that. That's not right. So my base is on now, so let's crack on with the rest of the makeup, otherwise it's going to be a super long video. Right, my base, apart from this, and I've said this so many times, I absolutely love this concealer from Makeup Revolution, even more than the Concealing Divine. I think next time though, this is C2, I think I'll get C1 and just see what that looks like. And again, I think I'll use this brush. So we're going to go in with the shade first. I used that in the first look. Just in the crease. Right, that'll be enough. I just want a tiny bit of colour down. And today we're doing first impressions on a couple of things, so I'll talk you through that when I've done the makeup at the end. then we'll do this one, which is slightly darker, just to define the crease a bit. So it's going to be a very peachy look. I love peach eyeshadow, especially for this time of year. It's really, really bad weather in the UK. I don't know if you can hear the rain bouncing off the window, but it's really, really bad. And this kind of makes me feel a little bit better about myself, putting on like nice eyeshadow like this. Peach really makes me feel happy. So yeah, let's just blend those two eyeshadows out. And then we're just going to put that gold shimmer on. So it's very basic. It's a very basic look. So that's that one there. Ooh, that's pretty. Ooh, pretty, pretty, pretty. That's nice, isn't it? Really like that. This one is more like a foiled eyeshadow, in my opinion. It's not like a shimmer. It goes on really, really bright. So that's what that looks like. That's the finished eye look. So let's pop that over there. Whoops. So yeah, this is the finished eye look. I need to do brows now, so let's get my brow pencil. Right, so this is one of the items that's on the chopping block. Guys, I really don't know how I feel about this. It's big, it's bulky, and if I don't like it, then it can be decluttered. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into this bronzer here. I'm not going to use any of the other products because I want to use my Too Faced Peach Glow palette. So we'll just use the bronzer. I might be decluttering this. Right, so now I'm going to use this MUA Skin Hydro Powder just to sculpt it out, and hopefully it will look a bit better. Yeah, so this one might be getting decluttered, which is a shame because I do like the highlights quite nice. Saying that though, it's not really got a lot of pigment. This blush is quite nice, but for the most part, if I don't like the bronzer, it's just gonna go. So that's that one. Then we've got Too Faced even Sweet Peach Glow. Really, really like this. Got it off a friend who didn't want it anymore, and I've not really used it. And obviously, as we're in spring now, I feel like this is the perfect time to use this palette, and also with this look as well. So let me go and get, oh, we'll use this one. This is like a blush and highlight brush, so we'll just use that. Oh, it smells so good. It smells so much nicer than the peach eyeshadow palette by Primark. Oh, I'm getting big wafts of it. Oh, this is the Primark highlighter that I got, and I was explaining yesterday when I did the Shop My Stash how alike it was compared to the eyeshadow palettes. So yeah, I can't believe how alike it is to Huda Beauty's eyeshadow palette. So I'll just do it again because it's only in this drawer here. So that's the eyeshadow palette, and then let's just do that. Look how similar they are, it's unreal. Only the diamond gem on this one is just a slightly bit bigger and it's taking over the package more, and obviously it's mad that they can get away with doing that. But this is what it looks like. It is a beauty. Can you see that? So it's just a white icy highlight. So let's open the packaging up. I've not used it yet. And Primark do four shades in this. Two of them are too dark and they do a more pinky one, which I think I'll go back and get at some point. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to dip my brush in the entire thing rather than just like on the outskirts of it. So yeah, let's do that. Quite powdery. Very glittery. Oh, I don't like it, guys. It's really glittery. Can you see how glittery that is? Let me see if I can do a hand swatch. Yeah, it's just really, really glittery. Let's see if I can blend it in a little bit. Maybe it will just make a nicer inner corner highlight. And I've just got it. I don't want to, you know, get rid of it. Want to play around with it a little bit. So let's try and put it in the inner corner. Really brightens up the eyes. I'm not gonna get another one, guys. I don't like the formula. I don't know if it's gonna show up. I'll only be able to see that when I'm editing it, but it is like it's got chunks of glitter in it, and that's not my thing. I don't really like anything that has glitter in it, so I'm just gonna. And you can't really see it as bad now that I think I just used the wrong brush. We'll try it again. Actually, we'll do a bit on my nose with this one. This one is the contour brush, but it doesn't matter. Right, so that's the highlight. I mean, even on my hand, I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but there's loads of glitter there. So yeah, that's a little bit of a flop. I'm really surprised at that. Primark normally do some of the best highlighters I've got in my collection. So yeah, that's a bit of a disappointing. Right, so I would normally wear like a neutral lipstick with this look, but I wanted to know if I still like the lipstick. I like it, just not with this eye look. So yeah, it would probably go with a different eye look better. And this would probably look better with the likes of this, which is what I was going to use. It's a Revolution lip gloss. really, really nice. So I'm going to take this to my mum's, and when this fades off, I'm going to put this on. I'll probably take an Instagram picture of it. So if you're not following me on Instagram, you could, if you want to, you can follow me over there as well. My handle is at beautywithandrea_. So yeah, I'll be taking that out with me. Don't really like the red lip. Love the eyes, to be honest. I think the eyes are really, really nice. I love that gold. You can't really see the peach that much. But yeah, I really, really like it. So let's get the palette and talk about this a little bit, as this is the main focus of the video. So this is the Just Peachy eyeshadow palette that came out a couple of years ago now. Primark brought it out, and I do like it. I'm not gonna sit here and slag it off. I do like it. I don't like this shade. It is very, very powdery. There's a lot of fallout in all the shades, to be honest. This one is the worst one because it is the darker eyeshadow out of the lot. Really, really like the peach shades. Love this shade here. So if ever I do declutter it, that one is going to be coming out. Love this one here as well. I don't think I've got anything like that in my collection, and this one here. So there are a few shades that I really do like and probably will keep the palette for. Before I said that, I was going to probably end up decluttering it. I still do want the Colourpop Baby Cart Peach, so yeah, I will still be getting that, and I am glad I've got this as well, just so I can obviously try it and see if I like the peach eyeshadows. Still really, really love peach eyeshadows, guys. So yeah, I'm glad I've got this in the collection. So we're gonna put that off to the side while we talk about this. I was so, so excited for trying this. I was so excited that Primark have done this, and it is so, so beautiful. I mean, look at how beautiful that is. Look how beautiful the design is on it. It's just chunky. It's just really, really chunky and glittery. I think I will keep it, but just kind of for an inner corner highlight, or maybe even an eyeshadow, like for a frosty white eyeshadow. It's nice for that kind of thing, and I'm glad I only got one. I was going to get two at the time, the two lighter shades, which is this icy white one, and there was a pink one. I'm glad I didn't do that. There's four shades in total, like I said earlier. There's like two gold ones and a white one, and then like the pink one, and they all had the same texture. And at the time I thought, well, it looks fine, it swatches fine on the hand, but I don't know if you can see just how glittery the eye on the face. We'll see when I come to edit the video. But yeah, it does look glittery, but it could have been the brush. I mean, I did use quite a big brush. I mean, that is quite a big brush for highlight, but it, like with my other highlighters, it's fine. So I thought it would be fine with this one. And then I went on to use this contour brush as well, to kind of blend it out and to put a little bit more on the nose area, and that looks okay. It doesn't look too bad. But yeah, I mean, I'm a little bit disappointed with that. And yeah, I do like that. So I like it, I just don't like the smell of it. You can't get this now anyway, I don't think. It never came to my local Primark anyway. Probably went to the bigger Primarks, and I've not been to a big Primark in a long time, so I don't think you can get it. Let's just see what they bring out for this spring and summer, because peach is known to be a spring and summer eyeshadow palette. But yeah, I've really been enjoying doing this Free Looks One palette with it. Thank you for watching. It's probably going to be an extremely long video again. Please like, please subscribe to this channel if you've not already done so, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys. Right, so I just thought I would jump back on camera. I was wearing the NYX Orange County lipstick before, and I just didn't think that looked right. I did say when I went to my mum's and the NYX Orange County came off, it took forever to come off that, by the way. Really, really comfortable to wear, but it just didn't look right with this look. So I put the Revolution what are these called, Nude Collection Gloss Lipstick, and it's in the shade Skinny Dip. Don't know if you're going to be able to see it, but it really is a really gorgeous cool toned lipstick. It's almost the same shade as, I don't know where I put it, but is it this one? Yeah, it's almost the same shade as this, but in a gloss. Let's put them together and I'll show you. So yeah, it's almost the same shade, but it's in a gloss. Really, really like it. So I just thought we'd jump on camera quickly before I start to edit this footage. So that's what we're looking like. The eyeshadow is still on, really, really nice. Don't know why I'm making all these funny faces. But yeah, I really, really do like that palette. I didn't think I'd like it as much as I do, actually. So I do want to get the Colourpop Baby Got Peach. Just had to think of the name. I also like the other one that they do. Is it Sweet Talk? But I like Baby Got Peach better. So I think I will invest in that very, very soon. But for now, yeah, we'll keep the Primark one. I've done like 3 looks with it and there's not really much more you can do with it, so I'm just going to pop it back in the collection. Well, I'll pop it back in the collection on Wednesday when we shop, sorry, next Monday when we shop my stash again. But yeah, for now it will be staying in the collection, and like I said, I might depot some of the shadows later on, and if I don't use all the shadows there, some are a little bit chalky, and obviously I don't want to put them on my eyes. So there are quite a few shadows in there that I really, really liked. Like this one on the lid. It's just a really, really pretty gold. Then there was a lighter gold, like a unique gold that I really, really liked as well. And a couple of peach shades. So yeah, I could put them in a Z palette. So yeah, this is everything for now. Thank you for watching again and I'll see you soon. Bye.